Ezekiel 25:17. I will carry out great vengeance on them and punish them in my wrath, when they will know that I am the Lord when I take vengeance on them. MiG-29 shutdown of MH17 confirmed, and Putin knew from day one Russia can hack American spy satellites, from therebel.org. On the 14th, the night before the G20 summit in Brisbane, Putin revealed a photograph intercepted from an American spy satellite that proves MH17 was shot down by a jet capable of hitting 35,000 feet. This move by Putin is probably why the Russian Navy is just off the coast of Australia. My guess is Putin will return to Russia that way. Well, I don't know about that. Anyhow, this is the picture. You can see practically the aircraft, MH17, and here a MiG-29 firing off a missile. And apparently, it got intercepted by the Russian Defense Ministry, and they say the direction of the entry holes in the cockpit region matched this photograph. This opens several questions and reveals some startling facts that Putin probably did not want to give up. First question: why was a spy satellite focused on the shootdown arm right when it happened? Spy satellites are a limited resource, and the fact that one was positioned to watch the shootdown proves it was no accident. Additionally, it proves the Buckminster story to be false. For what reason was that story told and pushed in the Zionist press? Second really big issue here, which would explain why Putin held onto this so long, it proves beyond a doubt that Russia has a perfect hack on American spy satellites. That is not the type of information someone like Putin would be excited to release. Why did he do it? This photograph proves the only possible technical reason for the downing of MH17 was deliberately shot down by a MiG-29 fighter jet, the best thing the Ukraine has. This explains why no one on the ground ever saw a Buk missile launch in relation to the downing. George Bill of MIT agreed 100% with Putin's analysis on the photo and said that beyond all doubt, this was the reason of the shootdown. The satellite photo, which shows a missile launch from the left wing of the fighter jet, is verified genuine because of the orientation of the fields of the ground below it, which met the shootdown scenario perfectly. We'll check out now the official report. Channel 1 from Russia. Well, that is from Wikipedia. I just wanted to inform myself on what the source of this release is, this news information release is, and that is Channel 1. It is also the emblem of Channel 1. It is government of Russia, owned by the government of Russia, launched on the 1st of April 1995, and belongs to the national media group, 25% in private hands, but it is practically an official news channel from the Russian ministry or the Russian government. It is a translated website of the original release by 1tv.ru. That is the official website that released, that an official government agency, news agency, that released these pictures. Months before the crash near Donetsk, a unique frame in the Anatolian program, however, and it also releases a video. And it describes in detail that a MiG-29 practically shot down MH17. Well, this newscast of 1TV.ru, the official government news agency, says, however, hello. It is known that a summit in Brisbane, Australia, Prime Minister Abbott has threatened to ask our president sternly question over Malaysian Boeing MH17. Let's try to facilitate his task, well, they say of, Putin. Back in August, Russian Union of Engineers published its report on possible causes of the disaster, then received fairly widespread in the media and in the internet. It received fairly widespread attention in the media and internet. Experts conducted a detailed analysis of all available information from all sources, made technical calculations and elaborated version of the causes of the destruction of the Boeing MH17. Expert conclusion: the only technically possible version, the defeat of the Malaysian ship with rocket cannon armament of another aircraft. We draw attention to one point in the report, the lack of any credible evidence launched missiles ground to air, while the so-called Buk system is accompanied by a cloud of fire, a deafening roar, heard within a radius of 10 kilometers, and contours which is fairly seen in the sky up to 10 minutes. Well, these are the Buk missile systems. According to Wikipedia, the specifications are basic missile basic missile system specifications. At the altitude, the range practically is 140 kilometers, but the altitude that it can reach is 25 kilometers, a minimum of 60 meters. These are huge, huge missiles actually, that can be heard from 10 kilometers distance. Plus, at the same time, they have radar installations that guide them. Go back to the article. In short, there was no buck. No starting from the ground in the presence of near disasters, dozens of professional observers from all sides and thousands of lay. No one has seen or recorded, well, there were no eyewitnesses, and the planes have seen or recorded, and it was not exactly the Russian planes. Expert arguments were heard on the internet report was translated into English and German. At the same time, we began to receive large amounts of information, among which was a different material, engineering calculations, and ultimately, the 12th, we got it here, said the first vice president of the Russian Union of Engineers, Ivan Andreevsky. I fully agree with the results of your analysis of the causes of the destruction of Boeing MH17, written by a man who introduced himself as a graduate of MIT with 20 years experience in avionics, George Bild. Boeing was shot down by fighter jet to haunt him. At first the crew fired the gun, then was struck by the cap missile air-to-air, when the right engine and the right wing were mazed with missile with thermal homing systems. We have an official government news agency of Russia, One TV, reporting and stating practically that experts have computed all possibilities, and that even some MIT guy is there working and telling them that what you're telling is the truth. And practically laying out the case and even portraying pictures, satellite pictures, they could be real, they really look real. I believe Russian satellites can do way better. Or American satellites. I believe these were American satellites and the Russians intercepted it. The so-called defense ministry with their listening outposts intercepted practically the transmissions of the satellites or hacked the satellites itself. That's also possible. But in this digital age, I believe it is possible to hack satellites. And that this was a release, official release, intended for the Russian-speaking population. Is this now a so-called propaganda ploy from this media outlet, from the government, to convince the Russian population that the West is evil and that they have to be liberated? Or is this practically an honest approach of the government or of this news agency to release information on the so-called truth or possible truth? Or do we believe the Zionist West-controlled media that tells us that we have to wait years for a research or investigation to actually happen, like they tell us over and over again here in the Dutch news? I believe that this is this information is real. At least those pictures are real. I believe this was a full-cycle operation from the very beginning, but it was not shot down by a Buk missile system, but by Ukrainian fighter jets, like in the Global Research website. Anyhow, they did not get what they were looking for, so-called confrontation or war, but this proves practically that the Zionist-controlled West wants a war of Russia, or at least to provoke a war or a future war in between NATO and Russia. Cheers.